Joe Biden had the largest public investment in social infrastructure and environmental programs that is actually finishing what FDR started, that LBJ expanded on, and Joe Biden is attempting to complete programs to address education, medical care, urban problems, rural poverty, transportation, Medicare, Medicaid, labor unions, and he still is working on it.
Republican Congresswoman Marjorie Greene, now a surrogate for the Biden campaign. Not really, but her attempts to attack him during a recent Turning Point Action event really fell apart because she decided to attack him on things that are actually pretty popular, and he decided to use that in a campaign ad. So good job, Marjorie Greene. Nailed it.
Yeah, so yesterday we talked about her speech and we were making fun of it because I'm like, what are you doing, an ad for Biden? So credit to Biden's team for being like, oh yeah, why don't we turn it into an ad? Because, but there's something deeper here. First of all, nice job on the Biden team. They're not normally this good, but hey, credit where credit is due. Way to take that and turn it around. Nice job. Okay, that's good politics. So now, but the larger point is, the reason Marjorie Taylor Greene said all those things is because she thinks right-wing voters don't want any help.
Right.
They don't want Medicare. They don't want transportation to be better. That giving money to education sucks. Like, and she said all those things derisively. FDR, what did he give us? Social Security. LBJ, what did he give us? Medicare. Isn't that terrible? And that's because she's dumb. Right-wing voters actually do love those things. And that's why I've often seen right-wing voters say, oh, like if Democrats were like FDR, like in the old days, then they'd be great, right? Why? Because FDR actually delivered for the American people.
That's right, yeah.
And LBJ through Medicare and war on poverty, etc. A lot of different programs that delivered for the American people. So they were complicated figures. They weren't perfect by any stretch of the imagination, but they fought and they won. And so she's exactly wrong. And it's not just that it's not going to work for independents and Democrats, and that's why it's a great Biden net. It's not going to work with the Republican voters either.
Well, okay, so let's talk about why it is that Marjorie Greene engaged in this misfire, this miscalculation, mm-hmm. right? And how it is that she easily won her reelection.
Mm-hmm.
It's because, look, I personally think that she's oblivious to reality on these economic issues because she's steeped in culture wars. That's all you hear from Marjorie Greene. We're gonna impeach Biden. We want to impeach Biden. Okay, I mean, like, look, and I'm gonna be self-deprecating here, okay? Because I was obsessed with getting Trump impeached, right?
Mm-hmm.
And honestly, at the end of the day, putting all your eggs in that basket, you're gonna end up incredibly depressed and demoralized, right? You gotta focus on what people are aching for, what people want in order to improve their lives. Now, a lot of American voters, both on the left and the right at this point, I think get distracted with wedge issues and culture war issues and aren't focusing enough on what candidates in either party are gonna do to actually materially improve their lives. But the distractions are real. They're propagated in corporate media. They're propagated in campaign speeches. They're propagated in now podcasts that members of Congress are hosting. That's the reality of our political landscape. So the reason why I believe Marjorie Greene is oblivious to how popular those economic programs happen to be is because she's not really thinking about it and she's not really dealing with it. Again, totally steeped in culture war narratives all day or a day. That's all she does.
Yeah, well, let me partly agree with you. The original mistake for Marjorie Taylor Greene is talking about economic issues. The Republicans do not want to talk about that under any circumstance other than to say, oh, inflation is bad, right? But if you said to them, okay, well, let's start to fix things, right? So since the price of all the food and everything else is rising, let's give people higher wages. Let's pass higher minimum wage.
Or stop corporations right. from price gouging.
Exactly. Then all the Republicans would go, no. See, you stepped into it because the popular positions there are almost all on the left, not in the right. That's why they almost never talk about economic policies. That's why they don't bring up Medicare and infrastructure and all these different things, right? So that's her first mistake right there, going into losing ground. The way she gets that turning point audience, which is very right wing, is to do culture war stuff that Anna's talking about. Like, oh, don't trans people suck? I meant, oh, protect the children. The crowd goes nuts, right?
Yep.
So that's a mistake, right? But now in terms of the impeachment, which is a little bit different than economic or culture war issues, that's partly strategic, etc. And this is why we call Marjorie Taylor Greene dumb. Because for the Trump impeachments, I think he did terrible things. I think they should have tried to impeach him.
Agreed,
But what we said throughout, as those things were happening on this show was, yes, but also fight for the American people on economic issues.
Correct.
And that's the part the Democratic Party leaves out every time conveniently because of their corporate donors, right? But when it comes to Biden's impeachment, Marjorie Taylor Greene introduced it on the first day. Hey, knucklehead, then by definition you're saying, I don't care what he does, I just want to impeach him because I don't like him.
That's exactly right, yeah, exactly.
Well, then that gives away the game, doesn't it, Marjorie? Like, then you're supposed to pretend, oh, I gave him a fair shot. But when he did that, fill in the blank, you're supposed to go, oh, that was crazy and unconstitutional, we have to impeach him. But she's not bright enough to know that. So she's like, oh, he hasn't done anything, let's impeach him anyway. That way we'll look like we're 100% wrong. Oops, right? And here she's like, oh, let's compare him to FDR and LBJ and really popular presidents from the past, who, by the way, the two presidents that won with the biggest landslide victories ever in American history, FDR and LBJ. Okay.
She nailed it. She really did nail it.
And let's bring up topics where we're really unpopular. Oops. So it's a rare win by the Biden team. Nice job.
Yes.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks. Really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.